Today, when you have, when people talk about things like Khalistan and all, very flippantly on news channels, etc. I mean, God's sake, you guys have no idea what you're talking about. I mean, you know, it was a, the whole state will go into a tailspin, the whole country will go into a tailspin. Aap baat kya kar rahe ho? Wo UK shuke mein ye groups aur ye Canada mein ye groups ye to saalon se allah macha rahe hain. Wo machate rehte hain, unko kya hai? They, unke to baap dadon ka khun nahi behega na. Jo yahan pe hoga, the repercussions here are terrible. So there are problems in all kinds of, in every state. There's problems in Manipur, there's problems in Assam, there's problems in Punjab, there's problems in Himachal, there's problems everywhere. But you have to solve them in a systematic way. Violence is not an answer. And I think what happened in the 80s, 90s, should be hammered home again and again to all our youth, because we must understand how horrific it is.
Welcome all of you to Sangam Talks. Our speaker today is a military historian. Very, very interesting, because it is, I think, political historians ka zamana hai. Aap Kullu mein baithe hain. He's written a number of books on military history of India. And today the talk is on his autobiography, The Life of an Indostani, 6 degrees of separation. I would like you to start with the name itself. What are the degrees of separation, sir?
Thank you, firstly, ma'am, for having me on your talks, and it's a privilege to be here today. Well, let me first say that basically I feel that autobiographies are a bit of an ego trip, and I wasn't particularly interested in writing it. But my publishers and everybody felt that, given the kind of lifestyle I've had and the various things I've been exposed to, it was more of a look at contemporary Indian history from the eyes of an individual. The only way to tell the story was to put it in the format of autobiography. I had worked with Gen.V.K.Singh on his autobiography. I'm his co-author there, so you know I knew what it entailed, and it was actually quite a roller coaster of a journey once you start writing it. The title, of course, is, you know, Hindustani is kind of self-explanatory, though. When we first started putting it out on social media, somebody told us, ki ye kaisi kitab hai, ko to edit kar rahi nahi aata hai, inka age bhi gir gaya. So I felt they are Pakistanis, they are Hindustanis, they are Afghanistanis, they are Khalistanis, why not have an Hindustani also? So yeah, it was. And 6 degrees of separation, because there is a, aap kahin bhi jaiye, whatever you do, you find that things tend to, you know, the same people tend to re-gravitate into your life. So, you know, I think it keeps happening in the book. So the big book, which I was very, very keen on doing, was the 1962 book, because my father's battalion was involved in the 62 war. I'd done a whole lot of movies by that time. I'd done the history of the Air Force. I'd done the history of the Navy. I'd done the history of the Army. I shot the Kargil War. I'd done the major films for India, IMA, etc. So I think I was also, in a way, preparing for this. Plus, the Northeast Trilogy allowed me to actually walk over and go to most of the areas in the Northeast where the fighting had taken place in 1962. So the 1962 book, actually, a lot of people have asked me how many years of research. I say, actually, it's about 30 years of research, because it's a book which, you know, whether it was Ladakh, my Tiger Top days allowed me to actually see and experience everything there. Then we Northeast Trilogy allowed me this whole thing. So it's a story of a defeat, the 1962 book. So I wasn't very sure anybody's going to read it, you know. I mean, I used to keep telling my wife at that time, ki, dekho, likh to raha hu main, par isko kaun padega? But the book has become, it's now acknowledged to be the most definitive work on the 1962 war. In fact, the Army has made it more or less mandatory for all its major courses, including Staff College. And the book is doing extremely well. I mean, you know, it's now it is considered the Bible. Because iske pehle, you had people like John Dalby, who had written Himalayan Blunder, and Neville Maxwell, who had written his own version of the whole thing. So and then this was followed by 1965, which is now a relatively old book now. Usko bhi abhi 2 saal hone ke. It's also doing quite well, but in many ways, I consider 1965 to be a more advanced and a better book than 62. But every book, again, has its own dynamics. So let's see how they actually do.
So I one, tell me about what I do not hear about the Northeast in the mainstream media, and also what is the kind of connect or disconnect in those states that you found with India?
Every time I've been talking about the Northeast, I've been doing a PowerPoint kind of a presentation. And I've been titling it as Blanks on the Map. Because, you know, we, the rest of India, the rest of post-1947, even before that, even in the British, in fact, more it was British policy. The Northeast was considered something very, very remote and completely, you know, inaccessible. When I started to actually, I was very determined to do this. I said, "Isko humne kisi bhi halat mein karna hai." So when we started to work on this particular Northeast trilogy, I began to realize that it's not just the people outside of the Northeast who don't know anything about the Northeast. Actually, I began to realize that people within the Northeast know nothing about each other. I'm not talking about, I mean, if you talk about Nagaland, Manipur, etc., wo to bahut bahut dur ki baat hai. I'm talking about tribes which lived on the left bank of a river and the right bank of a river. And there are problems which are, I mean, there are reasons for it, because, you know, you had head hunting and stuff like that, especially in the Naga Patkai region. As a result, there's been a, you know, each village was a kind of a isolated fortress. Then, given the political non-development of the area, the Assam Rifles was the only organization which was actually acting as a as any form of governance in the area. And, you know, it's an area which is very difficult to understand, because it's also very complex. It's not everything that is running along the Brahmaputra and the valley, etc. You have multiple valleys. Look at what is happening in Manipur right now. You have a major problem with the Maitis and the Kukis. This has been brewing for quite some time. And, you know, the problem has been that this kind of ethnic subtensions in the Northeast are there in just about every area. I mean, if you look at Assam, you have a lot of people who have migrated into the Brahmaputra Valley. There is a lot of, that is all simmering. It is all just under the surface. It all needs to be handled in a very mature and systematic way. Otherwise, it's a tinderbox.
So, have you made any recommendations or in your book itself?
Recommendations to my, I mean, you know, we are not really, ours is more of a window. It is where we are trying to show people, this is what the Northeast is, this is what it's about. In the 1962 books, etc., I have looked at the historical significance of the Northeast, as well as of Ladakh, etc. And, but there one is talking very specifically to the war. The people in the Northeast who are there currently, I've just come back from Arunachal, for example, they're all very queued up about what is going on. Everybody knows what the problem is, but the problems are very, very intense and they're not easy to solve. The especially where ethnicity is involved. You see, if you look at the map of the Northeast, right from the word go, it is like a map which is a moving map of populations. Kabhi, you know, Chakpans are moving into one area, this is happening in the other area. It is not a settled zone. Even the Ahoms, when they came in the 11th century or the 12th century, each one has carved a niche out for himself. And when you do that, you're always at somebody else's expense. So you have a problem with the borders, you have a problem, you know. So they have tried to tackle it over the years. They've formed a lot of autonomous regions. It's not, as I said, an easy problem to tackle. But you need very firm governance over there. And, you know, unless that is provided and good leadership, that's the only way out of the whole situation.
You made 105 trips to the Northeast while writing this trilogy. What are some of the most lasting, some of the events which had the most lasting impression on you?
Ma'am, 105 is actually what we did for the book itself. Other than that, we were also doing a lot of other stuff. The first time I actually really got to see Arunachal, it really, I mean, during the war, I was a three-month-old baby when the war happened. And I was 2 years old when the war happened. But before that, our battalion was in Valong. And my mother had was the only lady who was there at the battalion rear. And my father was from Tu Rajput. And the Thai Kamti Raja had actually built a basha, the bamboo hut, for my mom. And every night, there used to be tigers and leopards and all circling the whole area, etc. I've written all about all that in the book. So for me, the Northeast, the connect had been very, very deep. And then, of course, the war happened and our entire battalion got wiped out and stuff like that. The 105 trips that followed were, a lot of them were shooting for the Assam rifles also. We were dovetailing everything. It cost me an arm and a leg to make the Northeast trilogy. So the way we did it was that we were also shooting for the Assam rifles. We were doing their book. We were also doing a book for Three Corps. So, you know, people would keep coming forward because everybody believed that what we were doing was very important. So it was piecemeal we were doing all this. You know, when we were doing the book on Assam rifles, General Yadav was the DG that time. And I remember telling him, I said, so I'll shoot the Assam rifles book, but you've got to give me the freedom and the, you know, so that I can shoot the people as well. He said, how does that concern us? I said, it does concern you. So actually, even the Assam rifle book reflects that to a great extent. A lot of people say the Assam Rifles book is one of the best books they've ever seen. So, you know, everything fed off everything. The most, every trip, all 105 trips, believe me, were special. You cannot say this one was better than that one because area, wo ilaka hi aisa hai. Aap kahin bhi jao. Aap Tripura jaiye, aap Meghalaya jaiye, aap kahin bhi jaiye. The experiences are worth dying for and they live with you for the rest of your life.
Could you recount one or two incidents for us?
I'll tell you one. There was they had decided that because of the big danger being faced by the one-horned rhinos, it was decided to fly four of them from Guwahati to Delhi and take them to Dudhwa, because Dudhwa earlier used to have a very good population of rhinos, and so did they have rhinos in the across the border in Nepal at Chitwan. So it was identified. So they got four rhinos, three females and a male. And you know, rhinos have a habit of marking territory. They piss 10 meters. Unko ek ek crate mein aap dal ke Aerofloat ka IL-76 hire karke, these humongously huge animals were put inside this. And there was a Russian crew who actually, when you first saw them in Guwahati, I'm like, "Yare, baap re." You know, the IL-76 is a huge aircraft. It's called the Gajraj. Later, it flew with the Indian Air Force. Us time nahi the. And these guys came out in their banyans, and they were smoking these cigarettes, and their fingers were completely nicotine stained and all. And they said to they got a flight path cleared, where they could fly right over Everest. So imagine the scene. I mean, the IL-76 has this navigator's cabin where you can actually look down on Everest. You know, it's a glass cabin like that. So I've actually flown over Everest with four rhinos, you know. And later, I have a classmate of mine from Doon School, Ankur Behel, who climbed Everest. He's one of the oldest guys to have ever climbed Everest. He and his wife both. But I keep telling him, I said, buddy, you could have climbed Everest. Your wife could have climbed Everest, but nobody has been up over Everest with four rhinos, you know. So that was one very interesting thing. Then I had actually got shot in Kaziranga. So there were these poachers who had dug a pit, and the rhino has a fixed way of defecating. So piche ki taraf aata hai. And they put bamboo sticks. And when that rhino falls, the bamboo sticks go through the body. And then these guys come and they used to cut off the horn, because the Chinese believe it's an aphrodisiac. So it used to sell for 2 lakhs a kg or something like that. So we got into a gunfight with these guys because we were there when this rhino was inside. I wanted to actually shoot the rhino. And the forest guards said, we are not authorized to do it. So I said, give me the rifle, I'll do it. And just as I was about to, you know, fire into its skull, right, at point blank range, these guys out of the elephant grass came, and usi ke piche Brahmaputra thi, and we started chasing these guys. They got into the boat. And we fired a few shots, they fired a few shots, but I didn't realize it at that time, but I had actually been hit in the leg. So, you know, these things kept happening. Of course, later flew a lot with the Air Force in that area. I've flown a lot of fighter sorties over that, you know, over the Brahmaputra in the entire region, actually. Because we did these films for the Air Force, so we again got a fantastic opportunity to shoot just about everywhere.
So this is part of your wildlife shooting also. Anything about the Naxalite movement or the...
Yeah, well, it's there in Hindustani. I mean, I was shooting this film in Indravati in Madhya Pradesh at that time. Division nahi hua tha. And I had actually finished shooting in Timlipal in Odisha. And I decided to drive down from that side. I was driving alone with just an attendant. And the situation was, it was quite an eye-opener because I came through the Koraput district and the entire area was, that time was the starvation deaths. And I remember stopping at a hut and wahan pe ye, you know, wo jo tribal drums hote hain, wo mitti ke bane hue, wo, jo maine socha main do khareed leta hu. And, you know, when I got down, I got mobbed by the people there and they were actually pushing their children at us. Yeah, bilkul le jao, ye bach jayenge. You know, the bellies were swollen because there was no food. And the reason why one realized that Koraput was going through a major famine. And by the time we got into Madhya Pradesh, I expected things to be even worse because, you know, Bastar gets traditionally less rain than the Koraput region in Orissa. But strangely enough, Bastar was perfectly all right. There was no famine there. But again, Bittu Sahgal had connected me to Baba Amte's son, Prakash Amte, who ran a hospital called Hemal Kasa across the Indravati River. Wahan pe koi road kuch nahi thi. Hum wahan pahunche to humko, ma'am, it was 50 degrees in the shade. And believe me, it was so hot, it was almost unbelievable. I mean, you couldn't touch your steering wheel, you know, it was that bad. I used to have these canvas ki chhagals jo gaadi mein laga ke usme pani dalte the. And I remember on the first day counting, because I drank 86 glasses of water. And we wanted to shoot the Bastar buffalo, which amazingly I got very soon. I managed to film them almost immediately. But uske baad the whole thing was, let's try and get into the Abu Jabbar area, which is the most backward area of, and it was completely controlled by Naxalites. So Bittu said ki tum ye Prakash Amte ke paas jao and he will be able to connect you to these guys. So we had a hell of a time. I had to swim across the river with ek school mila tha jahan pe hum uske table ko raft bana ke le gaye, camera equipment leke, aur phir Prakash ke paas gaye. Prakash ne kaha ki dekho, main kuch nahi kar sakta. I can only arrange a meeting for these guys. I've sent them a message, you're coming. Aap log yahin raho. Unka mood karega, they will come tonight. Otherwise, they'll come tomorrow or day after. But now you stay put, now that we have asked them to come. So I did. First night, nobody came. Second day, at around 2 o'clock in the morning, hum bahar so rahe the, machhardaniya wagera laga lu, okay? And suddenly, one guy, a person came with a nakab, wakab lagaya hua. And mere saath phir machhardani, mere paon ke paas baith ke, machhardani ke andar, mere se baat ki. Aur mujhe pata nahi chala ki ye आदमी है कि औरत है या क्योंकि थोड़ी सी हस्की सी वॉइस थी. फिर उन्होंने कहा कि हम 4 बजे के करीब जब उजाला होने लगा, उन्होंने कहा अभी आप यहीं रहो, हम कल आके आपको ले जाएंगे. आपको, यू नो, दे आस्क यू की व्हाट, दे वर वेरी वेरी बीबीसी के साथ उनके कुछ वो ले गए थे एक टीम को, उन्होंने जाके पता नहीं क्या उल्टा सीधा रिपोर्ट मार दी इनके ऊपर. तो यू सी द बस्तर ट्राइबल आर, दे यू कैन नॉट जज देम बाय मॉडर्न डे सोसाइटी. आई मीन They are who they are. Just because they don't wear clothes and everything, it doesn't make them backward as such. बल्कि इसमें बाद में मेरा थोड़ा सा झगड़ा भी हो गया था, क्योंकि जब प्रोजेक्ट टाइगर की फिल्म बनी थी, उसमें शबाना आजमी was doing the narration, and she was taking up this whole thing for slum dwellers in Bombay, and she tried to link that with this, and I told her, I said, Shabana ji, आप कर क्या रही है? क्योंकि ये this is a complete. In fact, I stopped the shots. Then she very kindly understood what my point was, and then she changed. But anyway. तो अगले दिन ही आए और हमको ले गए अंदर, और वहाँ पे, यू नो, इट वाज फैंटास्टिक. आई मीन 4-5 डेज जो हम अंदर गए, एंड वहाँ पे मेरा एक असिस्टेंट था नायक, उसको कहते हम दाएं भी मत देखना, बाएं भी मत देखना, थोड़ी सी भी नज़र लगाई किसी पे ऊपर तो बार को एक एरो मार देंगे. तो यू नो, वी हैड टू बी वेरी वेरी कॉशियस. एंड ऑन अ वे बैक आई रियलाइज दैट द लीडर ऑफ द नैक्सलाइट ग्रुप वॉज एक्चुअली अ गर्ल who had done her PhD or something in in Osmania University. And she actually, you know, as we were getting back to Prakash's camp, I remember asking her, I said, you know, I'll never, iske baad tumhari kabhi mulaqat hogi nahi, aap apni shakal to dikha do. So, unhone kaha, तो ऐसे लगा जैसे कि वो पहले तो नकाब उतारने वाली है, फिर उसने ऐसे मुड़ के उससे कहा कि उतार तो दूंगी पर मैं उसके बाद मुझे आई हैव टू किल यू यू नो आई सेड नो नो थैंक यू वेरी मच आई थिंक आई कैन लिव विद द फैक्ट दैट आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू लुक लाइक इट वाज क्वाइट एन एक्सपीरियंस इट वाज क्वाइट एन एक्सपीरियंस
Your autobiography comments on the events of 80s and 90s, they say, anti-Sikh riots. So I would like you to pick out certain incidents from that book and tell us.
Well, you know, it was perhaps the most horrific times. You know, 1984 was a very bad year for India. We had a lot of problems. We even had we had Blue Star, we had the Siachen operations going on, we had all kinds of things happening. And I was with Associated Press that time, and one got involved in, you know, jab khabar aayi ki Mrs. Gandhi is no more. I had gone to the office, picked up some film, came out, seen, you know, what is going on. Pehle to kuch ho nahi raha tha sham ko, par phir gradually wo ring road ke aas pas Delhi mein, they started burning trucks, killing people. It was the most horrific thing I've ever seen. And ye sab chal raha tha, there was a lot of, you know, what should I say, a lot of tension. And I went back to the office to, you know, just go and dump the roles of film which I had shot. And if the fact say office pe koi tha nahi, ek Samuel hote the, who was always sitting in the office. Ye wo Narendra Place wali building hai jo Jantar Mantar ke paas, aajkal wahan DLF ki building aa gayi hai, unka jo main office ye barrack like lamba sa yellow building hoti thi. So jab main wahan pahuncha to we found that there was the sheaf of papers lying on my chief of bureau's desk, and I'm not prone to stealing things, but that day instinctively I just picked it up and put it inside my jacket, and I went back to my, I got onto my scooter, and फिर जंतर मंतर की वो जो एक पीली लाइट थी मर्क्यूरी लाइट उसके नीचे देखा कि ये है क्या, और देखा तो उसमें देखा कि ये अपना इलेक्शन लिस्ट है त्रिलोकपुरी की, जिसमें इन्होंने साफ साफ लिखा हुआ था. I mean, it was very obvious what's going to happen, because वहां पे एक दो नाम उन्होंने सर्कल किए हुए थे जहां पे उन्होंने पेंसिल से लिखा हुआ था डू नॉट किल, बाकी सबके नाम और एड्रेसेस की ये मौला है ये है वो सारा दिया हुआ था. तो अब आप बिल्कुल, मेरा तो खून सूख गया. आई मीन व्हेन आई सॉ दिस आई वाज स्मार्ट इनफ टू रियलाइज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई वाज लुकिंग एट. पहले तो समझ भी नहीं आता, तो फिर मैं करूँ तो करूँ क्या. तो आई यूज टू प्ले स्क्वॉश विद द एडीसीज टू द प्रेसिडेंट यानी जैद सिंह. तो मैं आता रहता था, इस गो प्रीटी ऑफन टू राष्ट्रपति भवन. सो इंस्टिंक्टिवली आई सेट ऑफ फॉर राष्ट्रपति भवन, बिकॉज वन ऑफ द एडीसीज वाज अ नेवल ऑफिसर कॉल्ड एसएस जमवाल, पेनू जमवाल, जैमी हु यूज्ड टू बी हिज एंड हिज फादर वाज द जीओसी दिल्ली एरिया. तो पता नहीं, आई हैडन्ट रियली थॉट इट थ्रू, बट आई लैंडेड अप इन राष्ट्रपति भवन, एंड कोई सिक्योरिटी नहीं थी, कुछ नहीं, सारी पुलिस हैड डिसअपीयर्ड, आर्मी ही वाज नॉट देयर. एंड आई पार्क्ड माय स्कूटर एंड आई रैन अप द स्टेप्स, आई हैव डिस्क्राइब्ड इट इन द ओपनिंग सेक्शंस ऑफ द बुक. एंड देन वहां पे एक एडीसी बैठा हुआ था, जेसीओ एडीसी भी होते हैं, नॉट ऑल ऑफ देम ऑफिसर्स, ही न्यू मी, ही नॉडेड टू मी, एंड आई सॉ द प्रेसिडेंट, ज्ञानी जी वहीं खड़े हुए थे. So I went to him, and I tried to speak to him, but I realized he's not understanding what I'm saying, because he was sedated. So फिर वो जेसीओ ने मुझे बोला कि साहब को रहने दो, उनको हमने वो थोड़ा दवाई ववाई दी हुई है. तो फिर मैं गया और मैं जमवाल के कमरे में जाके लेट गया थोड़ी देर के लिए. I just lay on his bed and I fell asleep. I must have slept for 15-20 minutes. When he arrived, तो उसने कहा, what are you doing here? And I said, देखो भैया ये लिस्ट है, अब आप बताओ क्या करना है. तो उसने कहा, उसने देखा, उसका भी खून सूख गया, हिस्से तुम सीधा जाओ मेरे बाप के पास. मैंने कहा ठीक है. तो ही रैंग अप हिज सिस्टर, सो वो मंदिर मार्ग में जीओसीज हाउस, ही वाज स्टैंडिंग आउटसाइड. बाय दिस टाइम इट वाज 9 o'clock 10 o'clock एट नाइट, आई डोंट रिमेम्बर द टाइम. एंड उसको लेके मैं अंदर गया, आई वेंट टू द हेडक्वार्टर्स, आई मेट द जीओसी, आई टोल्ड देम, आई सेड सर ये कल सवेरे त्रिलोकपुरी में होने वाला है, कल सवेरे का कब होना है ये तो हमको नहीं मालूम था, बट दिस इज गोना हैपन, बट लेट्स गेट, we need to put some troops there, otherwise there's going to be a complete carnage. But he wouldn't listen to me. He just he said I have no troops. So maine kaha sir troops bhi na ho, jitne bhi yahan pe sevadar wagera hain wohi de do, मच्छरदानी के डंडे लेके खड़े हो जाएंगे वहां पे, वो फौज को देख के वो डर जाएंगे. पर पता नहीं व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स वाज एट प्ले, बिकॉज नेक्स्ट डे यू एवरीबॉडी नोज व्हाट हैपेंड इन पुरी. एंड आफ्टर दैट ऑफ कोर्स वन इवेंट लेफ्ट टू द अदर टू अनदर टू अनदर. सो इट वाज अ हॉरिफिक टाइम. बुक स्टार्ट्स विद दैट एंड देन इट पिक्स अप द स्टोरी अगेन इन चैप्टर 7 और 8.
General V.K. Singh has said that the country owes you for revealing, you know, what was going on at the government, and the fact that you have called the Blue Star a botched up affair. Could you remark on that, on what politically could have gone differently?
He's referring to a particular incident which is related to Siachen. Siachen mein, whatever happened in Siachen, I think everybody knows, 1984 onwards, we've been holding the heights at 21,000 feet on the Saltoro Range. Lekin 2005 ke aaspas, it's all documented in the book, the then Prime Minister was under a lot of pressure from the United States government. They offered to, well, this bit is conjecture, but...
And who was the Prime Minister then?
Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister, and he started talking about demilitarization of the Siachen Glacier. Now, demilitarization to tab hogi na agar do sides hain wahan pe. Lekin since 1984, we have actually been holding Siachen completely. And Pakistan's presence is not on Siachen. This is a myth. Wo bolte rehte hain, hum Siachen pe hain, humne ye kiya, hamara Ked post, ye wo, sab, that is... उनके पास था पर उसको हमने वहां से हटा दिया था. तो पाकिस्तान की उस पर उनका पॉलिटिकल ये है कि हम सियाचिन पे बैठे हुए हैं. मुशर्रफ जी का तो ये बड़ा ड्रीम था ना, ही वाज अ ब्रिगेड कमांडर देयर. पर जब व्हेन द अमेरिकन्स मूव्ड इन टू अफगानिस्तान, दे हैड टू गिव समथिंग टू द पाकिस्तानीज इन रिटेलिएशन, बिकॉज यू नो ग्वादर वॉज कमिंग अंडर अटैक, दे वर अटैकिंग देयर कॉन्वॉय. सो The Pakistani generals wanted something in retaliation. Ki bhaiya, hum aapko, we will support you in your war in Afghanistan, but give us something to score brownie points with our own people. So the Americans had turned around and done to some extent, this is all piecing it together. And Dr. Manmohan Singh seemed to buy the idea of demilitarization completely. He discussed it with certain generals. I'm aware of it. I'll be fully aware of exactly what's been going on over there. Then General J.J. Singh ban gaye chief. And unke time mein ye thoda sa, Sanjay Baru ne apni kitab mein bhi iska zikr kiya. He raised this issue of demilitarization of Siachen with the chief when he first met him after becoming the chief. And according to Sanjay Baru, the general said it's doable. And the army was never going to agree to it. But, you know, you have the chief saying it's doable, then chalo phir. That started a whole process. You know, they went to Canada, they set up a group there. It's all documented in the book as to exactly what happened. And then this whole thing started to, actually was going to be implemented in 2012. And that time, General Prakash Katoch was one of the people who got wind of what's going on. But wo jis bhi channel mein jaye ya jis bhi newspapers mein jaye, jahan jaye, piche se PMO ka phone aa jaye. लाइन कट जाए उसके बाद कोई उसको हाथ ही नहीं लगे. तो ही कॉन्टेक्टेड मी एंड ही कॉन्टेक्टेड मिस्टर एम जी देवा साहेब, हु इज अ सोशल एक्टिविस्ट एंड IAS ऑफिसर, हु वाज अर्लियर इन द आर्मी एंड अ वेरी फाइन जेंटलमैन. ही इज अबाउट 80 नाउ एंड अनदर रियल पेट्रियट. एंड व्हाट हैपेंड आफ्टर दैट वाज दैट देयर वाज अ मैगजीन कॉल्ड जी फाइल्स, जो सिर्फ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स और सबको जाती है, जिनके एडिटर अनिल त्यागी थे. तो वो मान गए, उन्होंने कहा कि कुछ भी हो जाए, कोई भी प्रेशर आ जाए, दिस इज इम्पॉसिबल, दिस इज, ये तो बिल्कुल गद्दारी है, दिस इज दीज आर दीज गाइज आर ट्रेटर्स, वी हैव टू पुट दिस आउट. सो वी पुट दिस आउट एंड इट स्टॉप्ड द एंटायर डीमिलिटराइजेशन स्टफ एट दैट टाइम. बिकॉज यू सी द प्रॉब्लम इज कि सियाचिन में फर्स्टली वी हैव लॉस्ट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल, आई मीन कैजुअलिटीज वाइज मरे करीबन 1000 के ऊपर भी काफी लोग मारे गए हैं. और सबसे अब जब आप उसको होल्ड कर रहे हो, व्हेन यू आर होल्डिंग इट एंड यू पेड द प्राइस फॉर इट, व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ विड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम दैट, स्पेशली सिंस इट्स योर ओन टेरेन. आई मीन ये मिस्टेक हमने 65 में हाजीपीर में किए, या हम घड़ी घड़ी कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट का तो ये this was a hallmark of the thing that, you know, they were very reactive during their period. They would, something would happen, we would react to it. And then when we would even throw the Pakistanis out, whatever, chahe Kargil ho, chahe kahin bhi ho, फिर उनको बोलना कि चलो यूएन के प्रेशर में आ जाना है या ताशकंद या जहां पे भी जो भी हुआ है वी ऑलवेज हैंडेड थिंग्स बैक वी वर नॉट गोइंग टू लेट दैट हैपन एंड लकीली बाय गेटिंग ऑल दिस आउट जनरल वीके सिंह मेड दैट स्टेटमेंट इन दिल्ली व्हेन ही वाज लॉन्चिंग द बुक ही वाज रेफरिंग टू दिस ब्लू स्टार का तो बॉस्टअप ऑपरेशन तो मैं तो बहुत सालों से कह रहा हूँ कि इट वॉज मेरे बोलने से क्या होगा इट इज फैक्ट दैट जनरल सुंदर जी हैड actually told Mrs. Gandhi ki haan haan main kar dunga. General Vaidya, who was later shot by terrorists because of his so-called involvement with Blue Star. Balki woh to keh rahe the mat karo isko. And Sundarji was that time, General Sundarji that time was the army commander in Chandigarh, who directly aaye. General V.K. Singh ki kitab mein bhi humne iska zikr kiya of that meeting because he was present in the Prime Minister's house with the DGMO. And they had gone there to tell her that it's not possible. When General Sundarji comes, he bypasses the chief and he says, I'll do it. So, uske baad, jo hua to hua, uske, I mean, that's an, anybody who says, see, when you say it's a botched up operation, in fact, abhi General Bulbul Barar got very worked up and was saying, ki anybody who calls it a botched up operation is anti-national. Main kaha ki, sir, ab baat kya kar rahe ho? I mean, of course, I didn't speak to him, but the fact is that nobody's questioning their bravery. Nobody's questioning the guts and glory, you know, the whatever they did. Bina juto ke Harbinder Sahib mein goli di chalana, wahan se fire aa raha hai. Ye sab hua hai. Unko to aap, you know, nobody can say. But the higher leadership, and that points to the immediate planning, was a complete disaster.
Actually, Major Gaurav Arya keeps reiterating that. He says that there were a number of ways that you could have chased them out. And just kind of gas is one of the options where you could have done without it entirely, without a military intervention or an army intervention entirely. But it was not done. Do you have any comments to make?
In Operation Black Thunder, they did what they should have done in Blue Star. And you see, the other thing was that I was one of the chaps who, by pure chance, had been inside the Golden Temple and had actually interacted with Bindarwale. So, main us time Assam mein tha. And my father was also the Brigadier of 11 Corps at that time. And suddenly, you know, I started getting messages in Assam in the beginning of June, ki you better come back to Delhi because the Western Army Commander wants to see you. So, I flew out of Assam in pouring rain. In fact, that aircraft came, picked me up, brought me, took me to Chandigarh. I met the general in Chandigarh. And he asked me, he says, Kunal, wahan pe andar hai kya? मैंने उनको बताया मैंने कहा सर 64 LMGs है हम लोग ना जो फौज में पले हुए हैं हमको ये चीजें सब मालूम होती है वी आर मोर व्हेन वी वॉक इनटू एन एरिया एज आर्मी ब्रैट्स वी आर लुकिंग फॉर वी नोटिस दिस थिंग सो आई टोल्ड हिम आई सेड सर देयर आर सो मेनी वेपन्स ये है ये है ये है ये है एंड आई वाज आल्सो अ जर्नलिस्ट सो नेचुरली इट वाज माय जॉब टू काइंड ऑफ मेक नोट्स ऑफ ऑल दिस एंड आफ्टर हियरिंग मी फॉर अबाउट 2 or 3 minutes ही लॉस्ट इंटरेस्ट बिकॉज आई वाज टेलिंग हिम समथिंग व्हिच ही डिडंट वांट टू हियर तो मुझे कहते हैं कि यू जर्नलिस्ट एग्जैजरेट मैंने कहा सर आप मेरे को असम से लेके आए हो मेरे से पूछ रहे हो मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ आप सुनने को तैयार नहीं एंड माय फादर हैड आल्सो टोल्ड मी ये एक चीज याद रखना ये मेरा बॉस है इट इज माय बॉस डोंट गो एंड से समथिंग स्टूपिड टू हिम सो यू हैड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल इन डीलिंग विद हिम ही वाज अ मैन इन अ हरी हिज एंटायर प्रिजम्पशन वाज कि जब फौज आ जाएगी ये वैसे ही अपने आप हाथ ऊपर करके आ जाएंगे बाहर यू कैन नॉट प्लान अ मिलिट्री ऑपरेशन बेस्ड ऑन दैट And, you know, then you had absolutely no intelligence about what the hell's going on inside, etc. Now, interestingly, aapne gas ka zikr kiya hai, the aircraft which, there was a AN-32 which brought these canisters of gas from Gwalior, jahan BSF ke paas the. Wo jo gas thi, wo bhi expired thi. Uska bhi day by, you know, so there were problems which, of course, with hindsight, we can say we could have done this, we could have done that. But yes, I think the complete mistake was that A, going into the Golden Temple, we needed to starve them out. We needed to do whatever. But then, you know, finally, what did we have to do? We had to go in with tanks. And tanks have opened fire. Akal Takht ko to pura unhone udai diya tha. Uske piche ki buildings ke through aapke shells gaye. Pata nahi kitne log mare gaye. To aapko Yeah, Blue Star was a disaster, and you know, you have to be a little cautious when you're dealing with something which also impacts the sentiments of everybody. Uske baad we've had mutinies in the army battalions, you know, Sikh regimental center Ranchi went up in flames, all kinds of things happened. So obviously some more thinking needed to have been done.
And then the anti-Sikh riots, what do you think are the repercussions of that event till today?
I don't think India as a country can ever live down what actually happened in Delhi. It was horrific. Uska aur koi shabd hi nahi. So I think it showed us in our worst light ever. I don't know, I wasn't alive when partition took place, but I've seen photographs that it was a recreation of that. Uska repercussions to jo hain to hain, but uske 3 din baad ya 5 din baad, my chief of bureau Vicky asked me to fly to Amritsar in the first flight which went to Amritsar. And with me was a journalist from AFP. I was freelancing for AP by that time. And we both flew in, and we were the only two non-Sikhs. Baki sab ne apne pata chal jata hai, baal kate hue the, daadiyan udai hui thi, wo muh pe likha, kisi ke pattiyan lagi hui, kisi ka heart toota hua, kisi ka. Tension bahut zyada tha us wali flight mein, aur Dilip ka waise rang uda hua tha, because you know he didn't speak Punjabi. My mother was a Sikh, so I mean, my grandmother always spoke to me in Punjabi. So I could, mere ko Punjabi to samajh aa jati hai, main bol bhi sakta hu thodi bahut. So jab hum wahan pahunche to hum gaye Golden Temple mein, aur wahan pe panch pyare jo hote hain, the five granthis, uska jo head granthi tha ek the Sahib Singh karke the, not kad mein chote se the thode bahut. So unhone kaha ki main aapko interview dena chahta hu, ye humko message Delhi mein aa gaya tha. So I was carrying a Sennheiser mic and a Walkman professional recorder. So hum wahan gaye to sirf Punjabi mein bol rahe the, wo to bilkul theek Punjabi. So maine kabhi Punjabi mein kisi ko saath baat nahi ki thi. But as I said, my grandmother only used to speak to me in Punjabi. So I actually had to conduct this interview with him, and surprisingly I found myself fairly fluent. So I asked him, I said, what do you want to say, you know? So he said that from the Golden Temple, I am calling to all Sikhs in the world that, you know, what has happened in Delhi is absolutely this thing. I thought he was going to say, you know, let's calm down order. But actually he said that everybody should take a weapon and ready take revenge. And wo bol gaye apna aur ab kab karo to karo kya, aapke paas wo, you have the recording. And if we had put that out, it would have restarted the entire, jo thoda bahut simmering simmer down ho gaya tha, wo phir se shuru ho jata, and worldwide. So I didn't know what the hell to do. So I unhi ke kamre mein ek kala telephone tha. Unhone kaha ki aap baitho thoda kadha prasad. Despite all the chaos, they were still, he said, I'll get you some, I want you to have that. So okay. So I asked him, main aapka phone use kar sakta? उन्होंने कहा करी. तो मैंने वहां पे आर्मी का फोन नंबर लगाया, और जनरली मैंने आस्क्ड टू स्पीक टू द जीओसी जनरल चिकी देवाना. और मैंने कहा कि जनरली वो एक्सचेंज आपको ऐसे जीओसी को साथ कनेक्ट नहीं करता, क्या स्पीच है, कौन बोल रहे हैं. उसको मेरी शायद मेरी आवाज से ही वो समझ गया कि कुछ बहुत अर्जेंट है, उसने कनेक्ट कर दिया. तो आई टोल्ड, आई गॉट द जनरल ऑन द लाइन एंड आई सेड, सर आई गॉट दिस डे, I am now going to leave the Golden Temple and I'm going back to Mohan International where I'm supposed to stay. From there, I have absolutely no option but to pass this back to Delhi. And once it's gone to Delhi, it's going to be on the air because it is, you know, that's the way the media works. However, I'm telling you, I've got it. So if you want to intercept me in between, aap kar lijiye jo karna hai. Agar aap, so abhi, I was thinking like that, and I really didn't know what the hell else to do. So I stalled a little bit for time so that he would have time to get the police activated. And when we reached the lobby of the hotel, there was an SP sahab standing there. वो पैटर्न के जैसे अपनी पिस्टल्स भी ना वो होल्स्टर ऐसे उल्टा पहनते थे, उनको बाद में किसी आतंकवाद ने उन्हीं की पिस्टल ग्रैब करके उनको मार दिया था. बट एट दैट मोमेंट ही वॉज देयर एंड ही लुक्ड एट मी. हिज नेम वाज शीतल दास आई थिंक, आई एम नॉट श्योर. एंड ही टुक आउट हिज पिस्टल एंड ही ब्लडी हिट मी ऑन द फेस फटाक से कि यू नो गिव मी योर ब्लडी रिकॉर्डर. ये वो सारा वो निकाल खुल के पूरा टेप रिकॉर्डर का तो उन्होंने धज्जियां उड़ा दी. 1.5 लाख का रिकॉर्डर था. मैं तो मेरे एक दो दांत भी हिल गए. और दिलीप गांगुली जो मेरे साथ था उसको उन्होंने राइफल बट से मारा. पंजाब पुलिस कैन बी वेरी ब्रूटल व्हेन दे वांट टू बी. तो एंड देन दे टुक द टेप. और मैं वो कह रहा हूँ भैया मैंने ही आपको फोन किया था, मुझे क्यों हम लोगों को क्यों टोक रहे हो. दे वर सपोज टू मेक इट लुक ऑथेंटिक बट नॉट मेक इट लुक दैट ऑथेंटिक ऑल्सो कि यू गोइंग टू वेरी मर्डरस है. सो देन यू नो दैट वाज वन हेल ऑफ अ टाइम. एंड वी गॉट आउट ऑफ अमृतसर विद ग्रेट डिफिकल्टी बिकॉज some of the Babar Khalsa people got to know that this is what had happened and they were after us and everything was, so finally the GOC's wife, she is a Goan, mini auntie karke, we used to call her mini auntie, she said Kunal you don't worry, I'll get you out. And she gave us an army escort without tickets or anything. We were put on that Indian Airlines flight. She told the captain who took us to the airport, she said that look, if anybody tries to stop you including the police, shoot them. You know, it was such high tension. So it was a horrific time, and it was, you know, one lived through it. And it was today when you have, you know, when people talk about things like Khalistan and all very flippantly on news channels, etc. I mean, for God's sake, you guys have no idea what you're talking about. Yeah, I mean, you know, this it was the whole state will go into a tailspin, the whole country will go into a tailspin. Aap baat kya kar rahe ho? Wo UK mein ye groups aur ye Canada mein ye groups ye to saalon se halla macha rahe hain. Wo machate rehte hain, unko kya hai? They unke to baap dadon ka khoon nahi behega na. Jo yahan pe hoga, the repercussions here are terrible. So there are problems in all kinds of, in every state. There's problems in Manipur, there's problems in Assam, there's problems in Punjab, there's problems in Himachal, there's problems everywhere. But you have to solve them in a systematic way. Violence is not an answer. And I think what happened in the 80s, 90s, should be hammered home again and again to all our youth, because we must understand how horrific it is. These are not things which are... इसमें कोई दुश्मन नहीं है. इसमें आप ही अपने you are actually fighting yourself. अपने ही सीने में आप चाकू मारोगे घड़ी घड़ी.
There is nothing actually. I mean, I'm speechless. Mere paas, I don't have any more questions or after hearing what you just related. Anything else that you would like to recount?
Yeah, ma'am. One has seen a lot of things happen. I mean, like Kargil ki ladai bhi maine film ki thi. I mean, I filmed from literally within. उसके पहले 1995 आई हैड आल्सो डन अ फिल्म फॉर द आर्मी. दैट टाइम आई हैड एक्चुअली गॉन अक्रॉस एंड स्पेंट 4-5 डेज विद द हिजबुल मुजाहिदीन इन कश्मीर. एंड एक चीज मैं सबको बताता हूँ, वेयर एवर आई एम कॉल्ड टू स्पीक आई से लुक आई हैव ऑपरेटेड विद द सो कॉल्ड टेररिस्ट इन पंजाब. आई हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद द सो कॉल्ड टेररिस्ट इन कश्मीर. सो कॉल्ड मतलब दे आर, आई एम नॉट सेइंग सो कॉल्ड बट दे आर. Some people call them insurgents, some call them something, some call them. So I'm just using the word so-called. And I have not met one chap who is religiously motivated. These are bachche hain. Inko 24-25 saal ke aap kisi ke bhi haath mein hathiyar pakda dijiye, usko AK-47 de do. And there are only two things which motivate them. One is power, because suddenly everybody is standing in front of you. Ji, wo meri voti ke naal bhagya ki karna hai, usse haath kaat do ji. You are suddenly God. You know, you've got that kind of power. And the second thing is women, because they pick up women. I mean, you know, the kind of power you get at that age, and you know, the raging hormones and whatever. And in Kashmir, it used to be, I mean, I spent 5 days with the Hizbul Mujahideen because the army asked me to go across. And I did. I crossed over at a place called Sambal, and I spent 5 days there. I filmed some of this stuff. I came back with it. The chief at that time said that, General Roy Chaudhary, he said that ki, let's not put this out. It was pretty horrific. I mean, there was even, you know, just give you an example. There's a small little two-year-old kid. Usko baal se pakad ke AK-47 uske sir pe laga ke maa ko keh raha hai tu mere saath chal. You know, it's that kind of sickness. But everywhere one has seen this, you know, uske baad a lot of people write ki this was the reason, that was the reason, socio-economic, ye wo. These are just unemployed guys. And 99% of the time, let me tell you, I have not seen one of them doing namaz. I have not seen one of them praying to anything. They hide behind their religion and they take pot shots at the system. And I think those are the biggest cowards in the whole system. You want to actually, they are, I'm not saying that the system is perfect. There are a million problems. But for God's sake, this is not the answer. I mean, if you actually see a man die after he's been shot or blown apart, your life changes. I mean, Kargil ki ladai ke baad, main to hamesha kehta hu, abhi humne, hum Wellam Boys School mein, we run a military history seminar. Abhi ye 7-5 saal hai, and 6 years ago when we started, there was a lot of people who said, including a former headmaster, Mr. Dev Lairi, Wellam Boys ke principal, very respected. He put it on Facebook. What are you chaps trying to do? You're trying to create a military school. Ye wo. So I said, I wrote back to him. I called him up and I said, sir, contrary to what you are saying, every book on the armed forces, every film that's been made is actually an anti-war statement. If someone has seen a war, if someone has seen what can happen, you will pray this prayer every night, every evening, and every morning, that my children will not do this, this will not happen. You know, we are a country where there are a lot of fault lines. We have a lot of problems, as I keep repeating. But we also, I keep saying this in various forums, we have to start thinking like Fortress India. And to any chink, any crack, pani ke jaise wo ghus jayenge andar. You just have to be very, very careful. Yeah.
What do you foresee happening now in Kashmir? With the POK on the other side saying borders khol do, aar paar khol do.
Dekho, don't underestimate the Pakistani army. Okay, abhi tak unhone apna haath tak nahi dikhaya hai aapko. Aur ye sab hota rahega. Pakistan ki jo fauj hai, wo bahut hi bhaiyat aur bahut hi ajeeb kind of a force hai. It's an army with a country, not a country with an army. And the way they have neutralized Imran Khan, the way they have gone about the entire thing, inka to अभी जो POK में जो हो रहा है बॉर्डर्स खोल दो ये सब अच्छा है हमारे लिए लेकिन an unstable Pakistan is not a good thing from our perspective and for example अभी जो हाँ जो floods हुए हैं ये जो ये आपका पूरा स्पॉट एरिया में etc जहाँ 1/5 of Pakistan was completely you know very badly hammered the fact is that every time India has We as a country, in any case, in time of crisis, have always been very humanitarian in our approach. And it's a matter of time before. See, kab tak jhoot bolte rahenge apne logon ko? Ki hum Siachen pe baithe hue hain, humne Kashmir mein ye kiya, humne ye kiya. Inhone kiya kiya hai. Kashmir to isliye bacha hai kyunki inke haath nahi gaya. Agar inke haath gaya hota to bhagwan jaane aaj Kashmir ki kya halat hoti. So, and I used to tell that to a lot of Kashmiris also. You know, I used to say, what are you guys talking about here? तुमको जाना है यू नो तुम क्रिकेट मैच में बोलते हो कि हम तो जी पाकिस्तान के लिए झंडा लहराएंगे मैं कहा लहराए मैं 80s-90s की बात कर रहा हूं लॉट ऑफ दिस टॉक यूज्ड टू हैपन एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ गेटिंग एंग्री आई यूज्ड टू एक्चुअली टेल देम व्हाई डोंट यू डू इट व्हाई डोंट यू टेक अ टिकट एंड गो देयर एंड देन टेल मी हाउ मेनी डेज यू लास्ट टाइम बिफोर यू एक्चुअली कम बैक बिकॉज़ यू विल रियलाइज हाउ मच बेटर ऑफ यू एक्चुअली आर इन इंडिया तुम यहां बकवास तो कर सकते हो वहां जाके तुम मुंह खोल के देखो तुमको दो दिन में बंद कर देंगे So we need a mature and a stable Pakistan. And I think, you know, the newer generations which are coming, they are far more informed. Social media, there's a lot of misinformation also, which can be a double-edged weapon. It can become a bahut sari bakwas bhi chalti rehti hai aur polarization ke liye to sab log baithe hue. Lekin ye agli jo peedi hai Pakistan ki, ye ये फौज इनको कब तक इनको झूठ बोलती रहेगी सो वी जस्ट हैव टू बाइड आवर टाइम एंड सी व्हाट हैपेंस आई डोंट बिलीव कि पाकिस्तान में कुछ हो गया तो हमारे लिए अच्छा है या कुछ वो ठीक है उन्होंने हमारे ऊपर बहुत जुल्म किए लेकिन हमेशा every time khoon ka badla khoon se hi nahi hota hai, aur bhi tareeke hain.
You say that the newer generation is more informed. Okay, this will be my last question. But in the literary circles, in or the cultural, realm and area in Pakistan, they still have. I heard Anwar Maqsood in a speech the other day. He's more known for his program called Loose Talk, but he's a scholar and a narrator in his own right. And he said, "Maine inse pucha Shah saab se ki literature festival mein Hindustan se kaun aa raha hai?" Aur unhone bola Hindustan se to ab sirf dhamkiyan aati hain. Do you think that impression do you think general Pakistanis have that impression that India is the aggressive one?
They've been told a lot of untruths along the way. 71 for them as a nation is something which nation can live down a fact that it was dismembered into two. उन्होंने जो किया कैसे हुआ वो तो कोई नहीं देखेगा ना. वो तो हमको कहते हैं कि इन्होंने हमारा ये सिर काट दिया, हमारा हाथ काट दिया, ये कर दिया, वो कर दिया. तो पाकिस्तान के साथ सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम ये है कि वो उनकी जो इतिहास है, जो उनका जो हिस्ट्री है, जो उनको फर्स्टली ये भुट्टो जी ने शुरू किया था. ही स्टार्टेड टेलिंग देम कि यू आर नॉट फ्रॉम द सब कॉन्टिनेंट, यू आर मोर अरब, यू आर रिलेटेड मोर टू द अरब्स. व्हाट डिड ही सक्सीड इन डूइंग? He landed up making third-class citizens out of them in places like Dubai, etc. Because the Arabs look down on them. They say, we are Arabs. They say, what are you doing? We are not Arabs. So, Pakistan has to evolve a culture of its own where people start questioning things because the facts are very different on the ground. And history has a way. Propaganda can only take you this far and thus far. But I'm not saying the new generation is better informed. I'm just saying that new generation has more information available to them to draw their own conclusions. So that is what I actually meant when I said that. I am hopeful. See, look, there is no difference between Pakistan and us. All right, I have filmed the POWs in Pakistan after the Kargil war and stuff like that, and I used to really wonder what the hell are we doing here, what war are we fighting here? Who are we fighting? मैं कई लोगों को बोलता हूँ अगर आप जो अब इतना आपको इतना वो हो रहा है कि मैं हिंदू हूँ, मैं सिख हूँ, मैं मुस्लिम हूँ, मैं मैं कहा आप एक घर इधर पैदा हो जाते हैं आपका रिलीजन कुछ और होता. तो रिलीजन तो तब इट वुड हैव मीनिंग इफ यू एक्चुअली वर एक्सपोज टू इट एंड देन यू कुड चूज द रिलीजन यू वांटेड रादर देन वेयर यू वर बॉर्न. नाउ एवरीबॉडी हैज हिज ओन problems. Pakistan has its plenty of problems. It's an artificial country created by the British for looking after the oil fields in Iran and Iraq. Everything else. Uske baad aap likhte rahiye, humne ye ho gaya, ye ho gaya, ye ho gaya. Long road to Siachen mein to maine clearly ye puri kahani, I have actually devoted entire chapters to this where I've said that the entire thing was based on the British this thing. Humko sabko malum hai British ruled and divided, but actually what did they do? They had actually drawn up the plan for Pakistan in 1919. It's there in my book. And in fact, it was to be divided into three parts. Hindustan, Pakistan, or Princistan. I was saying, likha bhi hai, but Princistan will only be a bargaining chip to get the Congress into line. Jinnah sahab to yahan pe haath jod ke chale gaye 1930s mein, phir unko Churchill ne recruit kiya hai. I have written about it in my book. इसके ऊपर जो वाइस चांसलर ऑफ कराची यूनिवर्सिटी एट दैट टाइम हैड रेटिफाइड व्हाट आई सेड कि जिना वाज एक्चुअली वाज लिटरली रिक्रूटेड बाय द कॉलोनियल ऑफिस व्हिच इज नाउ द MI6. सो व्हाट आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट? पाकिस्तान सच एन आर्टिफिशियल क्रिएशन. बट ठीक है, अब वो एवरीबडी सबको अपना मुल्क बड़ा प्यारा होता है, झंडा बड़ा प्यारा होता है, पर सच्चाई भी कहां तक आप छुपाओगे?
There is one remark in the chat box. Thanks to Shiv Kunal Verma for sharing all his experiences and thoughts. It would help if we can get his opinion on how a layman or common people can support our government, particularly how can we prevent internal bad actors from hurting our country.
The current issue right now seems to be a lot of comments being passed by the opposition leader in abroad. I have absolutely no two views on that. आपको जो बोलना है, आपको जो करना है, आप यहाँ करिए. आप ये सब ड्रामेबाज क्यों कर रहे हो? आपको अपनी हिस्ट्री, आपको नहीं, it all boils down to history eventually. आपको अपना इतिहास भूल गए हो कि ये कॉलोनियलिज्म ने इन्होंने आपको क्या 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 हाल कर दिया था आपका. इन्होंने तो आपकी चड्डी किया, आपका सब कुछ ले लिया था, और आप उन्हीं के सामने हाथ जोड़ के आप चीजें चूचू कर रहे हैं. इंडिया हैज इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स कंट्री. आई एम नॉट प्रो बीजेपी और एंटी कांग्रेस और एनीथिंग ऑफ द सॉर्ट. आई एम प्रो इंडिया एंड आई बिलीव वी नीड अ वेरी वायबल स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑपोजिशन for a democracy to be successful. I think the opposition also needs to get its act together. You need to be able to literally have a kind of a shadow government which is actually, let's engage in something. Na. Abhi to notanki ho rahi hai. I mean, kabhi aap kuch keh rahe hain, abhi aap kuch keh rahe ho. So you really need a, I hope that, you know, we have the general elections coming up in 2024. For a strong, we are a country on the march. We have to, but because some things are going in our favor, it does not sweep away all our problems also. We have to face those problems. You cannot just say, it cannot become a propaganda exercise also. You cannot say everything is shining. Pichli bari India shining bola tha, to dekha tha, BJP ka kya haal ho gaya tha. So abhi, just figure it out. I mean, you know, we need a country which is absolutely rock solid. And again, I come back to using that same term, you know, which is fortress India. आप उसमें वो अपना अपने आप को एक किला बना लीजिए. उसके अंदर जो भी होना है, आपके problems आपके हैं. आपको अमेरिका आके हेल्प नहीं करेगा, आपको इंग्लैंड आके हेल्प नहीं करेगा, आपको कोई हेल्प नहीं करेगा. आपको खुद चलना है, और अगर आपको अकेले चलना है, आपके हाथ में एक मोटा डंडा होना चाहिए. वो मोटा डंडा अगर मेड इन इंडिया है और भी अच्छा है, तो बाहर का है तो शायद टूट भी जाएगा. क्या बोलो?
Yes, so the participant had clarified in the end that our enemies from mostly from within is what I mean.
Yeah, we've always had a problem. I've always said this, that the gates to India have always been open from within. In fact, हमारे अगर आप अंग्रेजों का भी इतिहास देखिए, the British could not for almost 100 years make any inroads in. It is only when the doors started opening from inside that they, before you knew it, the whole country was gone. So this country has to, we have to realize we are a very blessed lot. We have everything from the Himalayas to the oceans to the forest. We must aap ki hatheli mein rakhiye is desh ko. Aapko bade sari se nahi, har ek mulk ka kuch na kuch hota hai, lekin ye subcontinent jo hai, ye bahut precious. We just need to really look after it. You look after it, it'll look after you.